Hey guys, it's Kendall the Scientist, and I've noticed that you guys really like it when I read books, so today we are going to be reading Space Exploration by Adrianna Edwards and Ron Edwards. How we explore space. At night, we see the moon, thousands of stars, and some planets. We can explore space with our eyes. All we have to do is look up in the sky. To explore space more clearly, we can use a telescope. This tool makes faraway objects look bigger and closer. That way, we can learn more about them. Okay, so here's like a little picture of a telescope. Blast off. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off. How would you feel if you were in a rocket ship taking off for space? The force of the rocket would push you back into your seat, just like on a roller coaster. Finally, you enter space. What happens when you let the air out of a balloon? Air pushes the balloon up and away. A rocket works in a similar way. Burning gas comes from the bottom of the rocket. The gas forces it to lift off the ground and into space. So here's like a little demonstration of a balloon letting its gas out, and it's just like what a rocket does. Man on the Moon. Rockets made it possible for people to travel into space. People who travel in space are called astronauts. Earth's moon is our closest neighbor. It was the first place astronauts have ever explored on foot. What do you think the first astronauts needed to go to the moon? There's no air on the moon, so they needed special suits with oxygen to breathe. The temperatures could be very hot or very cold. Space suits had fans to cool or warm the astronauts, and lots of other things to help them survive. So here is a picture of an astronaut with all of his, like, stuff that he needs to, like, breathe and, yeah. Here you can see the astronaut with his helmet, his visor, his TV camera, and his lights. Everything he'll need to see and breathe in space. Moon landing. On July 16th, 1969, Apollo 11 blasted off for the moon. It took 4 days to get there, but after that, the astronauts walked on the moon for just over 2 hours. The world watched in awe. Neil Armstrong was the first astronaut to set foot on the moon. His footprints are still there. So here are the first astronauts ever on the moon planting the American flag. More moon trips. After Apollo 11, more astronauts traveled to the moon. They used lunar rovers to help them get around on the moon. Between 1969 and 1972, astronauts went to the moon 6 more times. Since then, no one has ever gone back. People have always been curious about the moon. Many people think they see a man's face in the moon. Can you see it? So here is a little outline of a man's face, and then the second one is an outline of a bunny. Yeah, it looks like a bunny. Next stop, Mars. We made it to the moon. What other places in space could we explore? How about our next neighbor planet, the red planet? Next stop, Mars. Mars looks red and hot, but it's actually very cold. There is water on Mars, but it's so cold that the water is all frozen ice. There's a lot more to learn about Mars. So here is the red planet, aka Mars. Touchdown! Other spacecrafts actually landed on Mars. In 1976, Viking 1 and 2 were the first. It took nearly a year to get there. They began to explore Mars. They tested the soil and sent many pictures back to Earth, but they found no signs of life on Mars. So this is called the Viking lander, and I guess it's the first spacecraft to be on Mars. Okay. After Viking, several other spacecrafts made trips to Mars. Curiosity rover landed in August 2012. It's still busy taking pictures, zapping rocks, and testing soil to see if people can live on Mars. So here is the Mars Curiosity rover. Martians. For many years, stories in books, movies, and TV shows showed little green men from Mars. Some people think that they are flying saucers, have come to look at Earth. But NASA says that there is no evidence of visitors from space. What do you think? So these are Martians. Some people know them as aliens. I'm blue, da-ba-dee-da-ba-dee. There are no Martians on Mars, but some astronomers think that there may be millions of other planets in space that are similar to Earth. These planets might have life. Some of these life forms might even be able to explore space. Beyond the Moon and Mars, the International Space System, aka ISS, orbits Earth. It is a space home for astronauts. The astronauts do lots of amazing experiments. They can stay there for weeks or even months at a time. They go there to learn more about space, about the moon, Mars, and beyond. The ISS helps us to prepare for space exploration. We already know a lot about Earth, the moon, and Mars, but what about the other planets in our solar system? We have sent many probes to Mercury and Venus. Voyager probes visited Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, and then kept going on. One of them is now 11 billion miles away. That is really far. Okay, so here is a picture of our solar system and all the planets. What's next? Why do you think people have not traveled to other planets in space? One of the reasons is that the planets are very far away. Missions to the planets would take a long time. For example, it could take 12 years or more to travel to Neptune and back. So here's a little, like, graph thing. And it says... Yeah. It says that it'll take... Mercury, it would take 52 days. It would take 100 days to get to Venus. Mars, it would take 210 days. Jupiter, it would take 1.9 years. Saturn, it would take 3.6 years. Uranus, 7.3 years. And Neptune, 11.4 years. So that basically shows how far the planets are away from each other. Okay, a spacecraft is small. It would not be able to hold enough food, water, heat, and oxygen to last the entire journey. Scientists are trying to come up with a better way to travel in space. They are working on ways to go further, travel faster, and stay safe and healthy. An elevator into space. Someday, we might be able to go into space without rockets. Some scientists think we could build an elevator into space. An elevator lets you go up and down quickly and easily. What would a space elevator be like? How would it work? Scientists plan to use a special kind of strong ribbon that would be attached from a platform in the ocean to a tower in space. People and things could ride special cars or spacecraft attached to the ribbon. So here's like a little example of like a spacecraft attached to the ribbon, so that way it can like zoom into space. Okay, and then here are some of the words that we learned. So it is probe, a spacecraft used to explore objects in space. Rocket, a long tube-shaped device that pushes a vehicle into space. Rover, a vehicle used to the surface of planets or moons. Space, the area above and beyond Earth. Spacecraft, a vehicle used to travel in and explore space. And then telescope, an instrument used to make faraway objects in space look closer and bigger. So here are the pictures of all of them. Thank you guys so much for watching me read Space Exploration by Adrianna Edwards and Ron Edwards. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!